Kneel. Before your queen.
I don't think so. It's not possible.
Darling, you have no idea what's possible.
Love strong women. Well, things are clearly not going Thor's way in the new movie Thor Ragnarok, in this case thanks to the goddess of death, played by Cate Blanchett. She joins Chris Hemsworth, Tom Hiddleston, a few other new faces for the third Marvel blockbuster, focusing on the God of Thunder. Eli's here with his take. There have been a lot of Marvel movies, quite a few of them with or about Thor.
Yeah.
Does this one measure up to that tradition?
You know, Goldilocks gets a lot of hate. I'm one of the few that actually have enjoyed the Thor films, loved the first kind of fish out of water vibe, the sci-fi twist in the second, but this blows those all out of the water because this is probably one of the funniest Marvel movies ever, and it's called Thor Ragnarok. So as you can see, it kind of blows up everything. So let's talk about the story. So Thor comes home to Asgard. He's looking for his dad, Odin the King. He's gone. And then he finds out that he has a new sister, the goddess of death, who, well, as you might imagine, not so nice. In the ensuing battle, he and Loki end up in an intergalactic outpost ruled over by the Grandmaster. That's why he's fighting the Hulk. It's kind of like a gladiatorial circus where they battle each other. Now, normally in the comics, the Grandmaster is this holier-than-thou being that forces heroes to battle, but in this movie, he's played by Jeff Goldblum. That's gonna change things. Let's take a look.
Is he any kind of a fighter?
You take this thing out of my neck and I'll show you.
Oh, listen to that. He's threatening me. Hey, Sparkles, here's the deal. If you want to get back to Asgard.
Asgard!
Any contender who defeats my champion, their freedom they shall win.
Fine, then point me in the direction of whoever's ass I have to kick.
That's what I call contender. Direction would be this way, Lord.
Goldblum, it's like he's tuned to another station that we don't hear. I mean, the choices he makes, the pauses, just sometimes the expression on his face is just so delicious. And it's not much of a complaint, but it's so funny that I think it almost undercuts some of the seriousness of the superheroes in that this is easily one of the most irreverent, out there, sardonic superheroes ever. And, you know, sometimes when you're talking about God of Thunder and the end of days, it's tough to have that tone and then switch to the comedy. So I think there's a question of consistency, but just in terms of pure entertainment, there's a lot there.
Is it the comedy then that helps this Thor version stand out the most?
It's really quite interesting. So there's this director named Taika Waititi, and he is from New Zealand. He's made some little films like Hunt for the Wilder People and What We Do in the Shadows, a hilarious vampire mockumentary. And so they've taken this guy with an indie comedy background and plunked him in to a $180 million Marvel movie. So as you can see from this behind-the-scenes footage, it still has all the bells and whistles. They have all the science fiction people, all the visual effects people to make it look amazing and have dragons and laser battles and spaceships. But at the center of it all, and there's Waititi, you have this guy who's basically an improv comedian. And so he will do scenes with Chris Hemsworth and Jeff Goldblum, and they do all the stuff that's on the page, and then they just try things. Try it again. Now try it again. Now what if I asked you to do this? Now what if I was a giant green monster? And you get that sense of looseness. Mm. That's where that irreverence comes from. That's why this is the funniest thing I have seen Chris Hemsworth do ever. I didn't know he could be this good. Now, again, I'm not sure it quite matches the Thor that I know from other movies, but it is a lot of fun. The other interesting thing about Waititi that you're seeing there is that he's also Maori. So he's the first indigenous director of a Marvel movie. Now, you might think the Norse God of Thunder, what is he going to bring to the God of Thunder? But it's a question of influence. It's a question of style and casting choices and even just the riot of color in this junkyard planet that we find ourselves that looks like Willy Wonka meets Tron. So that's where this Thor gets its unique flavor.
And it looks like the cast must have had so much fun with it.
They did. Everybody talks about the vibe on his set.
Mega movie stars. It almost looks gratuitous, the big names thrown in this film.
So I'm going to try and rank the cast because there's so many great stars. Let's begin with, it's kind of Abbott and Costello. Costello in space, Chris Hemsworth and Tom Hiddleston as Thor and Loki. He's kind of like the dumb jock that finally got in touch with the sensitive side. He's the goth boyfriend you always had a crush on. So much fun from then. And then moving on to Mark Ruffalo as Bruce Banner and the Hulk. I'm a big Hulk fan. The Green Machine has never been better. Hulk angry, Hulk sad, Hulk pout. You actually want to give the big green guy a hug. Cate Blanchett. Now, we always knew that she was movie royalty, but now she's truly a goddess. She just owns the screen as Hela, just purring as she skewers the competition. But my favorite might be a new face for you, and it's Tessa Thompson. There she is. She plays Valkyrie. She's an Asgardian runaway, drowning her sorrows with drink. You might remember her as the girlfriend of the boxer from the movie Creed. She throws herself into battle with such zest, with such zeal. I think she is my new favorite thing. She is going to be the next It Girl. She is Valkyrie, and it is glorious. And this is a hoot, 4 stars out of 5.
I'm sold. Thanks, Eli.
You're welcome.